What do Vision, T'Challa, Steve Rogers, and Bucky Barnes all have in common? Well, they're all considered to be a part of the Avengers, and they've all featured in the MCU films. But in terms of their abilities or their powers, one word, one atom, one chemical element comes to mind. Vibranium. In this video, I'm going to take a closer look at atoms, vibranium, and where you might find it on the periodic table of elements. Hi there, I'm Dr. Barry Fitzgerald, the superhero scientist, and on this channel, you'll find videos about the science and engineering behind superheroes and their superpowers, as well as other topics. If you're new here, please consider subscribing and ring the bell to get notifications of the latest videos. Right, let's get into it. Vision is back. Well, sort of, kind of. In any case, after Thanos forcefully removed the Mind Stone from Vision's forehead in Avengers Infinity War, I think it was safe to assume that Vision was gone forever. But Vision is back in the new Disney Plus series WandaVision, alongside his MCU and comic book love, Wanda Maximoff. Vision was created in Avengers Age of Ultron using Dr. Helen Choi's regenerative cradle. The main ingredients used to make Vision were a Mind Stone, biological cells, and vibranium. Vibranium, that's the same material you'll find in T'Challa's impressive Black Panther suit. And vibranium is the same material that you will find in Bucky Barnes' new bionic arm that he received in Avengers Infinity War. And that's the same arm that Rocket Raccoon is quite fond of.
Okay, how much for the arm?
Oh, I'll get that arm.
So could we make a Black Panther suit, a Vision, Captain America's shield, or Bucky Barnes' arm in real life? Well, the key material here is vibranium. So to answer the question if we can have vibranium, we need to talk about matter. We need to talk about atoms. An atom is the smallest unit of matter that can be a chemical element in its own right. And these chemical elements, they form the building blocks of all of the molecules that we find around us. The first atom I want to introduce you to is carbon. The nucleus of carbon atom contains 6 protons and 6 neutrons. It has 6 electrons in orbit around the atom. You'll find carbon in lots of objects around you. You'll find it in wood, you'll find it in fossil fuels, you'll find it in pencils, and you'll also find it in diamonds. Next up is hydrogen. And hydrogen is a special atom because in the nucleus of a hydrogen atom, you'll just find one proton. There is no neutron. Hydrogen, well, it takes part in a very important molecule along with another atom, oxygen. And when you combine 2 atoms of hydrogen together with 1 atom of oxygen, that gives you H2O, otherwise known as water. I've picked these atoms on purpose because carbon, hydrogen, oxygen, and nitrogen, which are represented by the symbols C, H, O, and N, are really important for the human body. We are CHON life forms. In fact, more than 95% of your body is made from these 4 atoms. But how do we keep track of all of these different elements? Well, the best way to do it is to use a table, and that table is called the periodic table of elements. Here indeed is the table. As you can see, there are lots of different elements on there. If you take a close look at it, you'll see that all of the elements have their own chemical symbol, and they all have other additional information about the atoms. The first periodic table of elements was presented by Dmitri Mendeleev in 1869. The table presented by Mendeleev did not include all of the elements we know now, and there were a lot of gaps left in the table as Mendeleev made predictions about where certain elements should be and where certain elements were missing. Let's quickly take a look at a couple of the atoms on the periodic table of elements. First off, this is hydrogen. I've left out one of the measurements that you saw on that table, which is the atomic weight. It's not important for what I'm presenting here, but there are 3 pieces of information that are important. First of all, you've got the chemical symbol, which is the letter or letters that represent the element. Second of all, you've got the name of the element. And the third one is the atomic number. And the atomic number is the number of protons that you will find in the nucleus of the atom. In the case of hydrogen, there's just one proton. Another example is oxygen. In the case of oxygen, you will see that it has its chemical symbol O, it has the name, and it also has the atomic number. And the atomic number here is 8, because in the case of oxygen, you'll find 8 protons in the nucleus. So where's vibranium on the table? I'm sure that's the question that you really want answered at this stage. If we start to take a close look at the table and search through it, well, you're actually going to come into a little bit of a surprise, because vibranium isn't on the periodic table of elements. Well, to be honest, that's a real disappointment. Vibranium is not a real atom. Vibranium is not a real element.
Whatever.
But that doesn't mean that we can't predict where vibranium might be on the periodic table of elements, despite the fact that vibranium doesn't actually exist. In a very cool scientific paper published in the Journal of Chemical Education in 2018, Sibrina Collins and LaVetta Appleby presented a very cool activity for the chemistry classroom. In the activity, students were required to think about vibranium, to think where you might find vibranium on the periodic table of elements, and to think about a possible chemical symbol for vibranium. In terms of a chemical symbol, V is the obvious choice. However, there's a small problem with that. The letter V as a chemical symbol is not available because the chemical element vanadium already uses the chemical symbol V. Well, that's not ideal, is it? But the students came up with an alternative to V as the chemical symbol for vibranium, and they proposed using VB, which kind of makes a lot of sense given that V is the first letter and B is contained within the word vibranium. And then, because of its amazing properties and the color vibranium has, particularly when it's absorbing energy or emitting energy, as we see Black Panther do so in many of the films, the students placed the element vibranium in a series of elements known as the superactinide series. Superactinide is a super cool name in terms of chemical elements that are associated with the superhero genre. However, elements with an atomic number between 121 and 157 don't exist yet. So it's kind of okay for the students to make a prediction with regards to vibranium being located in that superactinide series. We may not have vibranium yet, but if we manage to create it in the future, we have a pretty good idea of where we might find it on the periodic table of elements, thanks to, well, the paper that's been published by Sibrina Collins and LaVetta Appleby. In the meantime, we can still push forward with our plans to develop a Black Panther suit, or perhaps even a body like that of the Vision, or maybe even Captain America's shield, or what about even Bucky Barnes' bionic arm? We'll just have to wait for the material that is vibranium. I hope you've enjoyed this video in relation to vibranium, atoms, and the periodic table of elements. Please stay tuned for upcoming videos in relation to other aspects of superheroes, superpowers, science, engineering, and lots more besides. I've been Dr. Barry Fitzgerald, the superhero scientist, and until I see you next time, always think super.